I've been living on my bicycle for a year now. I've biked from Oregon down America, down Mexico, Central America, into South America. And people ask me, why do you live on a bike? Why did you quit your job? Why are you doing this? My answer is this. The routine is the enemy of time. It makes it fly by.
Hi, my name is Jedidiah Jenkins. I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. I'm the author of To Shake the Sleeping Self and Like Streams to the Ocean. As I was getting into my late 20s, I started to think, wow, people in their 30s are adults. Like, you need to know who you are in your 30s. And so I was like 27, 28. I had worked at Invisible Children for a number of years, but was very aware that like, I'm helping in my friend's project. Is this really why I'm here? Maybe. But it didn't, there was something buzzing in me that was like, there's something else you wanna do. Right away, I was telling everyone, when I turn 30, I'm quitting and I'm bicycling to Patagonia. And it really wasn't until my bike trip and wanting to become a rider where I stepped outside of that, coasting inside the fear of embarrassment. And that, I cut through the noise by understanding the scarcity of time. Like, you're just gonna coast through life in this middle place and never try anything. I read this Malcolm Gladwell book called Outliers, and in it he talks about this idea of people who are truly extraordinary at something have spent 10,000 hours doing it. And I remember thinking, what the heck would I even spend 10,000 hours doing? And the thing that came to my mind was, what is my favorite feeling? And wouldn't it be cool to give people that feeling? And my favorite feeling is when I read a book and then there is a passage in the book that is so good that I underline it. And I'm like, oh my God, this is me. And I was like, that would be my dream thing to contribute to the world, to write words that people underline. And so, you know, I started to have this cascade of thoughts. I'm now in this job, in this career, and I could see all of a sudden I'm 50 and I've been doing this, and now I have maybe kids, and like, I can't take risks like I could when I was just me. And so that's when I got the idea to go on like a really big bike trip and write about it. And I'm like, okay, when I turn 30, I'm gonna do this. But then I realized I'm gonna chicken out. So I need to tell people that I'm gonna do this and lock myself into it. And it worked, because then all of a sudden I was doing it and I was on the bike. And I think a lot of it rooted on the concept of scarcity of time. Like, I felt myself becoming a real adult, living my one and only life, and thinking, this is my life. And up until now, my life has been happening to me. Like, I didn't choose who my parents were. I didn't choose where I grew up. Even working at that nonprofit, it was just like the only good option I had. So it was like, as 30 was pushing in, I was like, I want to choose something for me. And if I crash and burn, okay, I'll figure it out. But at least I'll know I tried.
I wanted to know, like, what was going through your mind while you were on that trip?
Well, I definitely was scared a lot. Usually it was scared of making a mistake, of I had something that was good and fine, and now I'm risking a lot and everyone's looking at me and I could just embarrass myself. And that was this whole process of walking myself through that and being like, you know what? So what if you embarrass yourself? Even if you're a terrible writer, at least people will know that you're the type of guy who does stuff, that tries things. That's also a good thing. So I really did learn some of our biggest fears. If you actually walk the fear out, like pretend it happens, and then you imagine the other side and you're like, that's actually not that bad. So why am I so scared? Why am I frozen all the time, not doing anything? I spend so much time just excavating, who am I? What do I really want? I thought I wanted to be a movie director. Then I started doing that and I was like, well, I was wrong. So sometimes what we even think we want is actually just an invitation to peel back that layer and look behind it and be like, that isn't actually what you want. You're going deeper. And so the bike trip, becoming a rider, all these things is my journey deeper into myself and into my own life. When you're curious about something, just walk through that door and see where it goes, and you might find it.